Welcome to the Rebel Love Show. We are a once-a-week broadcast from Manchester, New Hampshire. We are pro-pot, pro-gun, and pro-coffee. You can find all of our content at rebelloveshow.com. I am Rob Mathias.
And I am the Rebel Mistress.
So it's been an exciting night today, isn't it?
It's been an exciting night. I mean, first off, I feel like we had an exciting weekend.
I know.
We were on the show like maybe a couple of weeks ago, and we were saying like we're gonna go to the beach. But I feel like this summer has like brought new things to us. So like, you know, we haven't been to the beach yet, which we're still gonna go to the beach a lot.
Well, no, you've gone to the beach.
I went to the beach once, and it was cold. But anyway, but we've been camping, like just enjoying the camping adventure.
People. It's kind of crazy. We go hiking all the time, going up. You know, hiking mountains, camping left and right.
It's really showing, like, with both of our weights. Like, I've been, like, so amazed at, like, even, like, my normal clothes that I wear every day are just, like, I can see a difference. And hooping, obviously. Everywhere I go, I want to just
like I said last week, I am dedicated. I've been working out, too.
I've been
keeping it going.
You have, babe.
You know, I've been slacking a little bit, but I'm dedicated.
Yeah, no, you've been doing good.
While I drink my large iced coffee from Dunk's.
Anyway, so this weekend we went on a nice friends camping trip up in Crawford Notch.
Yeah.
I love New Hampshire. I love the White Mountains. It just like reassures you, like if you're gonna move up here, like I say now, I'm advertising, you know, move to New Hampshire. Like, come. It's so beautiful. It's so like mind freeing. Like to spend like the night in the mountains under like trees, and I think it's beautiful. So there's so many reasons to come to New Hampshire, and
that's definitely one of them. exploration of New Hampshire.
Yeah, for the most part, we're not sitting still.
I mean, I've traveled a lot of New Hampshire in the 2+ years I've been here, over 2 years, and now I feel like I'm finally like actually exploring like every nook and cranny that New Hampshire has.
Do you feel like a local?
Oh, I'm so local. I'm more local than most locals.
Yeah, I feel like soon
I'm telling locals Have you hiked this mountain range yet, or have you gone there? Like,
yeah,
I know so much more about New Hampshire than most locals do.
It's gonna be great. It's gonna be a great summer. All the camping, all the things, all the festivals.
I know. So many festivals.
Haven't gotten your ticket to New Hampshire Hempfest and Freedom Rally, go get it. Come to our wedding.
For all the libertarians out there and stuff like that. That listen to this show and all the anarchists and whatnot. There's so many festivals, and go to NHM Fest, go to New Hampshire Hemp Fest and Freedom Rally. That is the festival to go to. There's like this whole festival scene, so many different music festivals like throughout the region, and that's a case around the country, to be honest. But like, it's like we've tapped into something that we never knew was there, and it's so amazing to like find like a whole scene of
but
like,
it,
amazing
it was calling
people.
To us.
Yeah.
But anyway, so it was very refreshing to go out today and do some activism. Like, I didn't know if I was gonna go, and I wanted to make signs, which I guess we'll get into like personal experiences a little bit after.
Well, I mean, to start with, like, we're actually breaking tradition here, because traditionally, the first Tuesday of every month, we skip an episode. We skip it for the New Movers Party, which is always held here in Manchester, the Welcome New People Moving to New Hampshire. But we're skipping it tonight.
Yep.
And it feels great, too, by the way. It's like we're covering something that happened today. It's more important.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely more important. Plus, I just want to kind of do my own thing and do activism and meet people that way. That's my new thing. But anyway, so yeah, no, it was definitely refreshing to kind of do some activism. I feel like, you know, we've been going, we've been having fun, and we've been camping and stuff, and that's been nice, and meeting new people. And just like, you know, relational anarchism, just like, you know, spreading it through experiences, which has been great, I think. And then plus the show, you know, I consider activism
because whatever.
We talk about liberty. It's I like getting out there because I consider myself an activist, because how many people can say that they've been to multiple protests? They go and they hand out signs and they talk to passersby and they're like actively standing, you know, up for something. I wish there were more people. But like that really puts me in my element and reminds me of, you know, why I'm here and what I want to do, like changing the world, like one person at a time, individual liberations of the mind. So it was great protesting, like even like the police checkpoints we haven't done in weeks.
Well,
I don't know when the last
coming
one was
up, but
it's on the 10th, I think.
Yeah, there's one I think coming up is it this Friday or next Friday?
Yeah.
There is one coming up. I don't know if I'm going to make it.
It wasn't like how, you know, it most likely used to be. But this protest was like so many people and new faces. That was very revitalizing.
This protest was organized by the former head of the Free State Project, now head of Foundation for New Hampshire Independence, Carla Gorecki. And she kind of organized this like kind of last minute. Like it was... I think she started like a week ago. Like it was relatively quickly.
But what I heard was someone donated like flyers and they went around the town like putting up flyers saying that, you know, this protest is happening. This is why I come and check it out. And I think they had a really great turnout because of that, because it wasn't all like Free State people. It was a mixture.
Yeah, there was definitely a mixture of people there. Big shout out to Webkeys, Ella Ren Chat.
Was it him?
He made the signs of saying, you know, we should take a picture of him. We passed one up when we were walking in. I forgot. But he made a poster, basically a flyer that he posted everywhere throughout Manchester, talking about the lockdown. Get answers at City Hall tonight or the date. And he put the date and time on it.
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah. And awesome. And thank him for that. Like, that's awesome. And then also there was a bunch of signs that people had got together and make. Like, I do want to make, like, new signs. I'll get into my signs, or maybe I'll get into it right now. So, you know, like, you go to protest, and you want to make a sign, and you want to make it stand out, but I believe, like, when you protest, like, you want people to read it, and if it's really long and wordy, and, like, people are driving, they can't really read your sign.
Yeah,
so you want to make it short and to the point. But then it's like, what do you want to say? Like, because there's so many things you can say, but what are you trying to convey? So, I mean, I feel like there's this whole, like, sign into making signs for protesting, but these were some great signs. I held a sign that said policing through fear, and it was great because our friend Emily held up a sign that said we aren't your pets, and I felt like they all just went together. Like it's like a process, it's like an order, like we're not your pets and you are policing through fear in the police state. This is a fucking police state, like all of those things. Lockdowns are for prisoners.
Yeah,
like,
so I'm going through the event. There's an event page for this stuff, guys, and I'm going through it right now and kind of showing it on if you go to rebelloveshow.com/live, I got up on the video feed, but there's different photos that were made. I love how it's Jeff.
Yeah, it's like a mirror. It says lockdowns or prisoners, and then that's very creative.
Yeah.
I didn't even know if we mentioned like what we were protesting, but this protest was against the militarization of the police and the legality of the lockdown and shelter in place order that took place in Manchester for about like 10 hours after a suspect was supposedly in custody. So we're going to just talk a little bit about our experiences, because we talked a little about it on a past show. Because if anyone lives in New Hampshire, Manchester specifically, they actually caught the guy apparently on our street. Like, I'm gonna keep saying apparently and allegedly, because obviously we don't know what happened, because they supposedly caught him at 9 a.m. on our street, but they had a shelter in place, which is a lockdown, a curfew, don't leave your house, for about like 10 hours after that.
After they caught the guy.
Yeah, they supposedly caught him at 5 a.m. They're circling helicopters and barricades up, you know, sniper rifles, whatever, guns pointed in people's cars, until about 11:30, 12. So, like, that was weird, and they weren't accountable for it. They weren't, like, explaining themselves. They weren't honest and open. You know, as your public servants, they should be letting you know, like, what's going on. Like, is it safe? Oh, have you caught someone? No, but instead, I feel like they were using this as an opportunity to test martial law. It was like a martial law practice test. How will people start reacting when the cops say, no, don't leave your home? No, I can come in your home without a warrant. I can search your car without a warrant. I can insert myself over you as your authority. I want to see how you'll react to that. So that's what it kind of felt like to me. So there was a lot of different feelings on it, and we have a video.
Yeah, when we come back, we're going to have video. I got video of Carla's speech before the council meeting, and video from inside the council meeting with people standing up. So we're coming back here at rebelloveshow.com/live.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire,
it is good so far. But what is this?
Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property.
I thought it was like she had access to our Google Doc for a second. I'm like, what's going on?
Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com. Not the press release up. All right, am I going to put music on? Oh, it's our commercial. You know, we never made an extra commercial, babe. We're going to. We never actually got around to do it.
Oh, maybe not.
Topics include sex,
drugs,
anarchy, and the police. We are your premier polyamory, hippie stoner, and all-around fun podcast.
We broadcast every Tuesday night at 10 p.m. Eastern on LRN.FM and RebelLoveShow.com.
Want some extra fun? Check out and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Subscribe to us on iTunes and Stitcher. And join the Rebel Love crew by liking our Facebook page at The Rebel Love Show.
We're just trying to spread the love
of a liberated world. Peace.
The three most important things you can do for LRN.FM are: 1. Let your friends know you're listening to LRN.FM on your social networking profile. 2. Buy the things you buy online through shop.lrn.fm. 3. Give $5 a month to the AMP program at amp.lrn.fm. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same great prices, and LRN gets a cut. Please do your online shopping at shop.lrn.fm.
She's not a fat cat.
Hi, oh my God, when she lands, she makes a thud, and she can barely jump. Today, when I sprayed her in the face, she tried to run like behind a little sofa crack, and she couldn't even get her head through. Like, she literally like bumped her head. It was like open.
You are over-exaggerating about Ash's studio cat.
Ash is overweight.
No, she's not. Don't be talking bad about her.
Babe, lift her up and then show her.
She has skin at the bottom. That's because she got fixed. It never healed. She's always had that skin. Her skin's been here the whole time. That little flag.
Like 65.
No,
Ash she just weighs looks more than
big.
A dog.
She just looks big compared to Ren because Ren's a kitten.
Bigger. She looks big compared to Riker.
What?
What do you mean? What?
Riker is not that fucking big.
Ash is not that big. Whose cat's face is this big? No way.
Ash is big bone. She's a big bone kitty, but she's not fucking. How do you hit that yet?
No, you're saying crazy stuff. VictimlessCrimeSpree.com. That's
VictimlessCrimeSpree.com. Did you know you can get news updates about what's happening with Liberty
her food
Radio Network
delivered
in the
way fix her
you
new
prefer?
Bowl of food, but didn't clean up the food. Did she knock
down? Hey, I had to go to work, babe. We're coming back.
Plus, you can stay in the loop by joining our Facebook profile at facebook.lrn.fm or follow us at Twitter at twitter.lrn.fm. It's all free. So sign up now at updates.lrn.fm for news updates delivered to your email box, facebook.lrn.fm to follow our Facebook page, and twitter.lrn.fm to receive our tweets.
Are you tired of governments murdering people?
My apologies.
I
don't know what I'm doing. I do not. I should not be behind a control. You want to take over? You want to take over on the over here with the mutant and the camera shots and?
I can. You act like I didn't run two shows by myself. You're just like a control freak. I was always cool and calm. Do you want me to run the show? Do you want to switch seats? I sit in the comfortable chair.
Next episode. You take the helm next episode.
Okay. You can connect with the Liberty Radio. I won't have a panic attack. 10 seconds, babe.
That's okay, I got this. LRN.FM.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. So I want to hop right into the videos that we have. Individuals got together and they testified at this Manchester City hearing, you know, holding police accountable. Because in honesty, these lockdowns are nothing more than behavior modifications for the masses. So it was great that people got up and spoke out. So first, we got a speech here by Carla Gorecki, who is the president of the Foundation for New Hampshire Independence.
Yes. Now, I'm playing this off of Facebook because I found this on Manch Vegas Alerts, no less.
Yeah, they don't like them. They don't like this, but they're sharing it. And, like, negatively, I guess. But you guys should go to Manch Vegas Facebook page and let them know what you think about it, because there's a lot of, like, cop-sucking. Sorry. I don't want to use negative language because I'm trying this relational anarchy thing. But anyway, listen to the speech.
And I want to sound the alarm to everyone in New Hampshire to be aware that we can never sacrifice liberty for security, no matter the reason. It is exactly in times of crisis that you should not give up your constitutional rights and civil liberties. To paraphrase Benjamin Franklin, those who sacrifice liberty for security deserve neither, and we deserve more.
You know, I gotta give credit to Carla. She does definitely keeps busy.
Crime
is down 20%.
She doesn't seem like she's burnt out at all.
So the narrative that Manchester is a crime-ridden city is not accurate. Yet, in the past 3 weeks.
Well, when you write books, like, it's probably easier to write speeches and stuff and go out and speak.
Yeah. All right. I don't know if I can take the pauses. You get the gist of her speech.
You can go find that on Manch Vegas Alerts.
Yeah.
Rob actually showed up like halfway through. You actually can see him in the video. Like, fast forward to you real quick.
Oh my God.
You can actually see him in the video showing up to take pictures and stuff. That was towards the beginning of the protest. But anyway, it was a good speech. I heard most of it. I think the greatest analogy that she used when she talks about when you're a hammer, everything looks like a nail. And it's the same for militarization of the police. Like, when you start driving around tanks, when you start driving around Bearcats wearing SWAT team uniforms on your daily runs, like, who is the target? Like, when they're the hammers, you're the fucking nail. Like, they're militarizing against who? It's you, not just criminals. A criminal to them is everybody. It's all of us. So it's just, I thought that was like the best thing that she could have said, because it really puts like in perspective everything. Like, once they are, like, you know, carrying around machine guns and pointing them in your head and enforcing martial law, like, you're gonna be
if you go to, say, like, the union leader, you'll see when they're covering the lockdown on the west side, which again was literally like a block from our apartment here. They're showing like Manch PD and state troopers with, you know, M16s or whatnot, like pulling them through windows,
like,
and stuff like that, walking around. During the city council meeting, I'll actually play this eventually during the show. There is a person that I know for a fact was not a pork at all. Drove all the way from Concord, because apparently she was walking around that night with friends. All right, unless I just literally don't know this person, but like talking about how she was held up at gunpoint by the Manch PD. Her and her friends were ordered to like walk backwards with their hands up and whatnot on their heads. They're freaking out for their lives because they thought they were going to die if one person just like slipped, like they'd shoot. Crazy stuff like that.
Yeah.
You know, like.
Especially like. Okay, so the thing I'm getting, like, you can go to these Facebook pages, and of course there's trolls, but there are people who are dead-ass serious. They're like, you should just let the MPD do their job. And there are statists who are like, even like, you know, you can support the Manch police and still support your rights. Like, they violated your rights
here. How
about
you support them to actually do policing and not treat, you know, Manchester as if it's Fallujah? You know, and that's what we're getting from Manch PD.
Yeah.
But that's not just a Manchester problem. It's like a problem
this is
in
spreading.
Every city
America. This just didn't happen in Manchester. It also happened in Laconia. There was an incident in California like a few weeks before that where you see these like shelter in place orders and lockdowns. And really, like, if you caught a suspect at 5 a.m., there's no reason that you should be enforcing martial law at 11 and bursting in people's houses with AR-15s and like pointing guns at cars. Like, it's crazy. Like, it doesn't make any sense. And especially when you ask them to explain it, like, they won't they aren't accountable. And that's something else Carla went into, that she was there because we all live really close. It's Manch Vegas,
this
baby.
This happened literally like a block away from where Carla lives. Yeah. It's not like she's like, you know, running to it, you know, chasing after an ambulance or something like that. It is not the
case.
She literally lives in this neighborhood
walking
the street.
She was walking her dog, as she says. You go watch the video, but she was walking her dog down the street, and like now she sees like all these cops like militarized, and she's like, "What's going on?" And she said they ignored her and said, "You need to walk down this street right now, and like no, don't say anything else. Basically, you need to hurry up and walk your dog and go home." And she's like, "Oh my god, like you can't even answer me, like you can't even, you know, tell you're supposed to work for me, right? You're supposed to be providing me a service, but you can't even explain to me what's going on. Am I safe? Like, and like, it's just crazy." Crazy. And this was at 10 o'clock when they supposedly caught a suspect at 5 a.m.
Yeah. And then Manch PD has yet to explain why they literally enacted martial law for literally 12 hours of a day. And they haven't explained it at all.
Yeah. I really just feel like it was a martial law practice test. Like, they used an opportunity to bring out their toys to play. Like, you know that in the event that something goes down, they are your owners. The men with guns can come get you. Men with bearcats can shoot you down.
That, like, all right, even if you step back, try and look at it from, like, you know, from a pro police perspective, like someone that's supportive of a Manch PD, all right, saying that they used the right amount of force to capture this person. Okay, I don't agree with that, but like, let's leave that as a separate thing. Where did they get? They captured the guy. They captured him, and they're like, "Nah, you know what? We're just gonna control the city or the West Side. We're just gonna show our presence for the next 12 hours and not have to explain to anyone why we're doing that."
Yeah.
And that's what they did. And that's what they're still doing.
And there are people who just, like, support them blindly. Like, every other comment on this, like, fucking Facebook post is just, "I think that the Manchester police officers were just doing their jobs. I'm glad they put the shelter-in-place warning so that we can be extra safe." But, like, can you explain to me, safe from what? Like, that's everyone's question. Like, if you can explain to me what else you needed to look for 10 fucking hours.
I don't think it's...
Then okay, maybe I'll agree with you. Probably not, but it just makes no sense.
When you have people, and I'll play this one from Brittany Peng did like a heart wrenching talk where she's like crying. When we come back, I'm gonna be playing a bunch of videos, very short ones, only a couple like a minute long of different people speaking up at the city council meeting earlier today.
I'm Ian Freeman, host of Free Talk Live. We've been covering Uber for years on the radio with their ongoing legal cases.
Of course you have,
Ian. Defending your right to give people rides without asking.
You know, I'm feeling like a little McLovin's right now.
I need
a little McLovin in my life.
To meet new people and help Uber.
McLovin's are one of the headlining acts over at New Hampshire Hamfest. I highly recommend, if you haven't bought tickets, to buy tickets now, because it is coming. It's coming fast. Like 2.5 months from now, it's gonna be intense. Go get your tickets today. All right, NHHempFest.com.
For the McLovin's, we're gonna play a song for you that's on our album. So buy our album if you like what you hear. Take it away, Jake.
Well, some folks' conversations don't shed much light for me. Cut out from your magazine.
Thanks, but no thanks. Good name.
Thanks for what?
Thanks, but no thanks.
Oh, yeah. I thought that was a great name of the episode.
Yeah.
Throwback to the heyday of Keen. An homage title. I thought people would like it.
Don't shed much light for me.
Thanks, but no thanks.
Cut out from your magazine. I'm not much for nutshades or the cat girl on me. Caught up in the loveless scene.
Wow, they updated Snapchat. Look at this.
It's like,
yeah. It looks hot.
Yeah, I like it. I like it. Instagram on the other hand.
Oh, oh, that's what they're showing for the side. Okay. Cross paths with the preacher who told me Sam's. Yo, I have to say, Luke Radowski is by far my favorite Snapchatter.
He's
in, he's over in Europe covering the Bilderbergers. The Bilderberg meeting 2016. I think he's in Copenhagen.
Want to be my partner with sunset and trouble. Yeah, I'm with that sunset and trouble. Some folks' contemplations are not so bittersweet, left without the ways on me. Left without the ways on me. Harmful explanations of lies that don't deceive.
Issues.
It burns me like a fever dream.
Stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on doing the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. When you amp Free Talk Live, you get perks like access to the AMP only Facebook group and AMP podcast. Visit amp.freetalklive.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. We're live here on LRN.FM. We're also live on IPM Nation. Go check them out. And you can go watch us live at rebelloveshow.com/live. We're also taking Skype calls if you want to Skype in. Skype username, Rebel Love Show. So we're at this protest earlier today against the militarization of the police force here in Manchester. And I got queued up a video here by our neighbor Brittany. She's on her way with a second, by the way. I'm jumping to this is actually the second video of people talking, speaking their voice to the city council. So I want to play hers because hers is heartfelt. And I haven't heard any of these. I don't like to go into state institutions.
Okay.
You're a hardcore anarchist. I am not.
But anyway, I held signs the whole time.
Yeah, so I contributed. You're representing outside while I was representing inside.
Okay, let's go.
Yeah, all right. So here we go. I got one. All right. Go to rebelloveshow.com/live. Check this out, guys.
I had messages from concerned family and friends nationwide. My home was apparently on lockdown. I could see empty police cars out of every window, some of them less than 20 yards from my home, with police officers standing outside of their cars holding rifles. Sometimes there was only one, sometimes a group of four or five, and I could hear multiple helicopters flying overhead. I was concerned to take my dogs out to use the bathroom. What would happen if one of them barked? Would a gun be trained on me? I did not take my one-year-old son to daycare. I did not go to work. What would happen if I took my car out of its parking spot? Would a gun be trained on us? This continued for hours. Roughly 30,000 were led to believe that there was an active threat, an active shooter, an active reason for the militarized police presence and tactics like shelter in place. I was scared for my family being surrounded by police. I was scared for my neighborhood being in active danger, and I was scared my boss wouldn't understand that I couldn't leave. For almost 5 hours, the Manchester Police Department knew there was not a threat in my neighborhood. My testimony is a demand for answers. Why was I confined in my home when the threat was in custody? Why were so many officers in my neighborhood when the threat was in custody? Why were the officers' guns drawn? Why were so many resources wasted to secure a neighborhood not in active danger? I would like answers to these questions, and I don't think that's unreasonable. Thank you.
So, wow, that was that was intense.
Right?
That was intense. Yeah, that was so good. Like, what did they say? Did they say anything?
No, the city council didn't acknowledge any of that. They didn't talk about it at all.
I figured. Yeah. That's what happened.
They adjourned right after all the different people talked.
They didn't say anything.
No.
That's such, like, this is what I mean. Like, I'm going to go into this, like, ice cold, like, prison torture, like, I don't know, like, temple of, like, evilness and sit down and like pour my heart out like Britney did, asking why was she like almost murdered by the police without even an answer? Like, why are her kids like have guns trained on them if they were to go outside? Like, and she can't even get an answer, and they can't even acknowledge that, and that is the state that these fucking people serve.
They don't care. From their perspective, look, you got to understand, like, from Manchester knows that, like, there's a lot of free staters and anarchists and stuff like that.
But
in
people
Manchester.
Should care about their own civil liberties.
It doesn't matter. They probably hate us because of who we are, not because of what we're saying. And it is what it is.
Yeah.
Look at Keene. It's a perfect example.
I mean,
it's not about what they're saying, it's about who they are.
I mean, some old guy did come up to, like, Randy, which I haven't heard his speech yet. Saved the best for last, I guess. And was like, oh, I liked everything you had to say.
By the way, Randy did blow it out of the water.
So
congrats to him.
He dropped the mic.
I will play that
He'll
later
be
in
last.
The show, trust
but
me.
But anyway, no, yeah, that was very emotional. It almost made me cry because it's just sad to think about. It almost made me cry. I'm just not that emotional. Anyway.
Yeah, I would not cry from it, but it was
intense because, like, I mean, when I'm a mother, it's just like you got to think like everyone's your child. Like, what if that's your child that gets killed? Like, what if like one slip up can like get you shot dead? And only thing they would say is "oops," and you know you're dead.
See, the reason why the video I just played is was so much more meaningful in that, because you know how I talked about how there's a pro cop guy.
Yeah.
All right. Well, this guy would have run before her. Well, not right before. Well, one person before her, but nonetheless was right
probably
before
the Manch Vegas
okay.
guy.
And oh my God. This guy went on this like whole tirade about how like I respect what everything the Manch PD does. When I saw that that school was on lockdown, I was a parent. I knew throughout my heart that they were doing everything possible to save my child.
Yeah, they missed like, one day of indoctrination camp.
All right.
Must be serious.
And then, like, it was this was
they're
like,
being indoctrinated
like,
at home. Like complete, no need for school.
It was like the complete opposite. So like it really, it was like dropping the mic type of thing scenario when Britney went on. So that's why like it was so even more impactful.
Yeah, that was great. I'm so glad that so many people got up to speak. You know, sometimes I don't think anyone will, and that's kind of scary. That's even scarier to think. So I'm glad people actually took a stand.
Well, Randy's was actually they had already had enough people like lined up, and then like no one else was left, and they did ask like was there anyone else who'd like to speak, and two other people walked up,
nice.
One of them being Randy, which I thought was
and he had nothing prepared. Like, he didn't write his speech.
No,
like,
yeah, he wasn't prepared at all.
It doesn't matter because it's easy to like ask these questions when you care and like about yourself and your rights. Like, everyone should care about that stuff.
I also saw that he was interviewed by local news, so I'm hoping that gets out.
I got asked to be interviewed as well, not by local news, by a girl writing her thesis, so that should be fun. But anywho,
hot.
But yeah, no
protests. See hot women.
Yeah. Anyway,
I don't know if you follow me. If you follow me on Instagram, that seems to be the case. I do some activism, be around a bunch of hot women all the time.
Anywho, yeah,
move
but it was a good crowd out there, and there was a lot of news coverage, and just even the cars that honked in support. Though there was a lot of negativity too. Not a lot. Yeah,
what's all this negativity? I only caught like the last 15 minutes of what was going on outside. So,
okay,
you know.
Since I got 2 minutes, I'll
you
tell
got
you.
This, babe. You got it.
there were good honks and a lot of support. So I don't want to say it was mostly negative. So, you know, I was holding up my sign. I also wanted to hold up the peace symbol. So the first negative comment that I got was...
Was it get a job? I was asked this on Free Talk Live and I could not
was
answer
it get a job?
The question.
No, it was, what do you want to bring? You might as well bring Gandhi here, you fucking idiots. Yeah, that's what he said. He said, go get Gandhi and bring him here, you fucking idiots. And that was like the dumbest thing that I had ever heard. But like, it was true. But he was saying it like in such a derogatory way. Like, I was like, did you feel stupid after you said that? Because that didn't even make sense. Like, you hate... You're so against what we're saying. Do you think Gandhi's stupid? Like, because we're advocating peace and not violence? Like, what the fuck does that even mean?
I don't know. Yeah, that means
like
absolutely.
I can't piece it together.
I don't know what that
means.
We
should bring Gandhi here, like right here, and like we should all chant and like realize that these fucking authoritarian assholes have gained control over you. But anyway, so that was the first negative comment I got, which was stupid. It was just really stupid. And then after that, it was a guy who honked, but like kind of aggressively. And then he said, yeah.
Like in a good way or bad way? Like
bad.
Sometimes aggressive is like, yeah.
No, it was like,
I love you guys.
It was like, fuck you guys, honk. And like, we need Trump.
Okay. Oh, that it was a Trump honk?
Yeah. And then he said, then he yelled, we need Trump. And I was like, okay, like, I guess. Anywho, so we got another video when we come back.
It's going to be Carl's.
And I'll tell
video.
You about the worst. The worst anti-protester. The worst.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. I know this sounds unbelievable, but at my house, we saved as much as 45% off of a new item on Amazon. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveitpurse.com. I love my Magic Mud. I drink a lot
of coffee.
All right,
I can't do this. I can't.
Then I found my Magic Mud.
I gotta play music. I'm sorry, guys. I was trying. I was being lazy. I've been called to duty. All right, some music time. Who we haven't heard? Ooh. Annie in the Water. Let's check this out. Annie in the Water. I think it's bluegrass. You think it's a bluegrass band, babe? I haven't heard them yet. What do you think? Do you think this is going to be bluegrass? Ooh, I'm already excited. There's a Gadsden flag in the background. So this is Annie in the Water. They're going to be playing at New Hampshire Hempfest in Fremantle. Go buy your tickets at nhhempfest.com. Ooh, I love this already.
My hand, and you'll never run. link on your social media and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.FM. Download it now, free.
You bringing it back, babe?
LRN.FM.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage daily precious metals.
I got 30
update.
Seconds.
In early trading Tuesday, gold is down $7 at $1,241 per ounce. Silver is
off 47.10. Yeah, it's literally like 10 seconds after the 47 mark.
It's 46 right now.
Yeah, but I went like 30 seconds in the 46. I was counting in my mind, but I'm on Shire time, so like the timing is wrong. I remember that when I'm counting seconds.
Just don't count in your mind. Just don't do that. It's that simple.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, or promote.lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. This is your Rebel Mistress here. And if I haven't mentioned, you can Skype in if you want. Or else you can watch us live on rebelloveshow.com/live. Or you can just go there and click the link. Anyway, so I was going to tell you about the worst protester that we had.
Yeah,
and then we're going to play this video. So this guy, as Rob went inside the indoctrination facility, I waited outside.
No, it was the headquarters for all headquarters. Of the
For Manchester.
Manchester.
Anywho, so as he went in there to sit and talk and pour his heart and they jacked off and then left. I was outside telling cars that they need to realize and stand up for what's right. Anywho, and so there are these two guys that are like, what do you mean? Like, we need the cops. If it weren't for the cops, you'd be getting raped right now. And I was like, what? Like, that is crazy. Like, no, thank you. I don't want their service. Like, if it like it's men with guns are going to come help me not be raped by you, who's going to rape me because I don't like the cops. So it just didn't make sense. And then he said, oh, and your house is going to burn down without the cops. You're going to have a burnt down house and be raped. And I was like, I didn't realize that policemen were firefighters. So it's just like all not making sense to me. And he's just like, yeah, well, you better watch out. Soon you're going to have a burnt house and you're going to be raped. And he was so for real. And it was like, so, he was screaming like about raping us, like in front, like across, walking across the street from like our protest. So everyone was just kind of looking at him.
What?
But like, them, yeah, it was weird. He was just such an asshole. Like,
wow.
And I'm like, yeah, you're making such a good case for yourself. Like, you love cops and you also want to rape and burn my house down. But
well, no,
you're
no,
so
he just thinks that's gonna happen. Apparently, you know, I don't know if he actually believed that. But
I mean, I
like,
felt like
crazy.
He felt like he like without
think,
cops
think,
he would do it.
You think he would rape you?
And that's
you
why he loves cops, because cops are keeping him from like burning down houses and raping me. Apparently, so secretly he's just an arsonist raper. I don't know what he meant.
You know, whenever people
like, are angry, like they say
police,
crazy shit.
Yeah,
they like, get violent.
Support, yeah, they show their true colors. But like whenever you bring up no police to a pro police person, they immediately go to like, you know, there's just going to be people killing and murdering and raping and, you know, pillaging.
In fact, you should
blah,
die,
blah, blah, blah,
you
blah.
Stupid hippie.
Yeah.
Like, it's 0 to 100 real quick. And, you know, I feel like these people are just, like, repressed, like, psychopaths. And they feel like they need order some way. But, like, it's only because they've been indoctrinated. Like, they went in these sheep camps and they came out baaing. Bah. Bah. That's all they know. That's all they know. So if you go against it, like, they just go straight to violence because that's all they know. Like, they're desensitized to fucking war and rape, apparently. I don't know. But anyway, so play this next testimony.
Yeah, so this is Carla's little speech to the Manchester City Council earlier today about how, you know, the Manchester's being all military and shit. So here we go.
All about what, in my experience, having grown up in South Africa and
your
a police.
Name, your name and address,
I'm sorry, Carla Gunnick, and I live in Direct Court, Manchester, West Side. I brought some photos that I would also like to pass around. I don't know if that's something that is allowed, but this is basically police action that has taken place in Manchester over the past couple of weeks. And I think it's important to see maybe the world the way we're seeing it. As I've grown up in a police state in South Africa, I have seen this sort of escalation of militarization of police happen over time. We know this is a national trend that is happening nationwide, and I don't think it's something that we want to encourage or see more of in Manchester. I met this morning with Chief Willard at the community coffee meetup, and I feel like we had a good conversation. He stressed that these orders were voluntary, and I think as a beginning point, then that needs to be something that is clearly communicated to the community at large when something like this happens. It's also important for the police officers to understand that people who choose to exercise their rights to move freely are not criminals, and that they should be free to go about and do things that free people do. I have spoken to several legal scholars at various universities, as well as the ACLU and the NHCLU. I believe that there might be a class action suit that could arise from the situation that happened on May the 13th. And the irony here is that if that lawsuit were to prevail, my property taxes would likely increase, because ultimately taxpayers are held accountable when the police overstep their mark. And I think that's a really important thing for folks here to consider. I would also like to see questions answered, like some of the other testimony here, including which law enforcement agencies were involved, which federal agencies, according to Chief Willard during the press conference, were involved in the actions on that day.
30 seconds.
For the federal agents, I would also like to know under what authority or color of law they were acting. We also need a full explanation as regards the delay between the time the suspect was apprehended and the time that the community was informed that there was no longer a danger. Finally, I ask that we do an audit of the costs that were involved in this, and we figure out who's going to pay for it, and it better not come out of my taxes. Thank you.
Laura Bennett.
I feel like she nailed it. I thought she did a great job with the talk, you know.
Yeah, it was pretty good. I mean, I heard her speak earlier, so that was good. Sorry. So
So hey, I saw you were looking at photos. Was that Yuri posting that? Who posted those?
No, apparently Manch Vegas Alerts posted a bunch of photos.
Seriously, I gotta take a look.
But they were really good. They were really good photos, but I thought it was a friend who posted them.
Oh, and then they tagged you in it? Is that
yeah,
what's going on?
Yeah, and then
here?
I wanted to untag myself.
Oh, wow. They got like 45.
They're really good, actually. Okay. I mean,
are they doing like hit pieces on this? Oh, hey,
they're just like posting the information, but I do want to kind of untag myself.
Okay, well, I got the. Yeah, well, we'll figure out how to tag you during the break if you really want to. Why don't you want people to know who you are?
Because it's just like the back of my. Like, anyway, so.
I may or may not have just passed someone who may or may not be WebKeys, just saying.
Oh, okay. Well, I mean, I thought they're pretty good photos.
These are great photos, so. Yeah. These are actually really good.
I don't know. People are annoying.
You know what? This is a huge key to saying, like, you know, activism is real. And you know what? When you do on-the-street activism, you know, Manch Vegas Alerts covers what happens in Manchester. Like, they get a lot of views. Like,
yeah.
Locals look at this. A lot of locals. I remember I got into a debate with someone on Manch Vegas Alerts and coworkers talking to me about it. Like,
oh, you know,
like, you make Manch Vegas. Like, this is, like, a very popular
Facebook
page.
Oh, that's nice
page.
You're sharing them. I didn't even realize you were doing that. Oh,
yeah, I got up on a live feed. So, like, I'm showing all the photos that this guy took. He took a lot of great, like, here's a copblock.org poster that someone has right here.
Yeah.
So like there's a lot of great photos. I missed a lot of this.
I think the guy who runs Manch Vegas is against everything. Like he's pro cop apparently. But yeah. I don't understand these fucking cop suckers, because if you're pro cop, like if even if you are pro cop, like why do you think, like, what you're, that means you are nothing. You have, you hold yourself in no esteem. Like, you're okay with, like, the cops just, like, shitting on you, and that just is okay with you. Like, you don't have any self-respect, basically. So, I don't know. There were some great signs, though.
Yeah, these are some fantastic signs. You know, sometimes a lot of signs suck.
Who watches, like, The Watchmen?
Yeah, that's a good one.
No,
I love these stop signs that say police state. Like, those are fantastic. They're catchy. I don't know who printed up, but whoever did, kudos to you. I thought that was impressive. I think I bumped shoulders with this camera guy because he has a lot of similar shots that I took.
Yeah. I mean, you are a pretty good photographer.
He's still going.
If you go to Manch Vegas Alerts and you look, you could see, like, how big this crowd was. I feel like that brought, like, new energy, because even though I'm kind of upset that some people don't even care about their rights or that they're human and shouldn't be owned, as long as there are people, like, even a small group of people can change the world.
Oh yeah,
I think.
These pictures show a huge crowd outside City Hall. And kudos to Bill D. He's got a sign: "Be free, hide indoors."
More speeches, testimonies when we come back.
Understanding your credit score is the first step towards managing and improving.
Put it back in my head.
What? Say what? Nothing.
Nothing.
Okay, I am going to put, this is a long break, and this is my pee break time. So I'm going to put on, let me see here. Pat Foley Band. I've never heard them. I've been looking at this.
See Dave Ridley there?
No, I have not met Dave Ridley. I'm getting to the point, I think he's a fictional character that's, purposely hiding from
I've met him.
I know you've met him. Never met the man. Been here for 2 years. He's a recluse. Never met him. Anyways, put on some Pat Foley Band here. They will be playing New Hampshire Hempfest coming up this August, August 25th through 28th. You can buy tickets right now at nhhempfest.com. Tickets are under $100. I'm going to be honest, that is a steal. Get it now. Don't you fucking wait. Go buy tickets at nhhempfest.
Song, hardest to empty, soul to set black. No.
prosecutors report a petition calling for the removal from the bench of the judge whose sentencing in a high-profile Stanford University rape case has sparked outrage and attracted close to 100,000 signatures as of Monday. Santa Clara County Superior Court Judge Aaron Pesky last week sentenced former Stanford University student and athlete Brock Turner to 6 months in county jail for the sexual assault of an unconscious and intoxicated woman in January 2015. Opponents have accused Pesky of being too lenient on Turner. Pesky also attended Stanford, according to a biography provided by the League of Women Voters. The petition calling for his removal from office, posted on change.org on Saturday, attracted over 95,000 signatures by Monday evening. Maria Ruiz, a Miami nurse who authored the petition, said she was outraged when she heard about Turner's sentence. The change.org petition encourages people to file complaints with the California Commission on Judicial Performance. The agency declined to comment, citing the confidentiality of complaints. Ruiz also listed 45 different recipients in the petition, including U.S. Senators Dianne Feinstein and Barbara Boxer. Neither senator has immediately responded to a request for comment. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Frustrated Superman fans told reporters Monday that the economically healthy and financially stable Daily Planet newspaper is now the most unrealistic aspect of the comic book's universe. Acknowledging that enjoying the adventures of a superhero that can fly, lift cars over his head, and shoot beams of light out of his eyes requires some suspension of disbelief, longtime readers said even the comic's most exciting stories are regularly ruined by the implausibility of a thriving daily newspaper whose advertising revenue and circulation numbers have not at all been threatened by a media landscape overtaken by laptops, smartphones, and aggregation websites.
Look, I could play along with Superman using his breath to freeze a volcano or clapping his hands together to cause some sort of sonic boom, but seeing images of a thriving Daily Planet newsroom not facing layoffs or dwindling home subscriptions just really takes me out of the story. No one in Metropolis has realized they could get news online faster and for free.
This is the Onion News Network.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Forget you, Rob. Forget you.
You
and
know
your
we're
face.
Going the bumpers in Anywho. Case I don't have a beauty edition. You know.
No.
You're not a newbie at this.
You put it
you
on.
This.
You put it on. I wasn't even speaking.
Well, speaking of, do you know where the lighter is? I don't know what happened to it.
Anywho.
I'm going to go whole. Wait. I think I might picture.
Shut up.
No, fuck, I didn't.
Anyway, so as you know, or if you're just tuning in, you can Skype in Rebel Love Show. And we're talking about the protest we attended earlier today at Manchester City Hall in protest of the militarization of the police and the legality of the lockdown that happened in our neighborhood, which was just really odd. And there are a lot of unanswered questions. So Rob's going to play another video of a testimony that happened today.
Yeah, this is by another person in the community. I know they live, I think they live on our street, to be honest here. Let me get it queued up here for you guys.
Laura Bennett, I live at 444 Dubuque Street on the west side.
Yeah, that is our street. It's Dubuque. She's our neighbor. She's a neighbor of ours.
Is there any way you can turn it up? I really love living on the west side. It's a great neighborhood, and its safety is very important to me. On Friday the 13th, during the lockdown, however, I wasn't so much afraid of the suspect on the loose as I was at the heavily militarized police and SWAT teams and canines and helicopters patrolling my streets. If the suspect would come to my house, I could easily defend myself. I could shoot him, and that would be okay. If a SWAT team demands to come into my home without a warrant, if I say no, I don't think I stand very good chances in that circumstance, and that concerns me. Whether it was ever officially called a state of emergency, the lockdown in essence was such, and I think that There's no real place for that. Free people should be allowed to move around freely. We shouldn't be ordered to stay in our homes. We shouldn't be so afraid that we have to stay in our homes. When states of emergency or lockdowns are ordered like this, it seems to me that it's nothing but an excuse to toss our civil liberties out the window, and that alarms me. I only moved to Manchester about a year ago. I'd really like to stay because I like it here, but that lockdown in my neighborhood causes me to rethink if this is a place that I want to live, if the police department is allowed to take action such as that, overstepping their bounds severely. So I would ask all of you to hold them accountable for their actions and not let this happen again. Thank you.
That's all we have here.
All right, so...
Cool, that was a good one.
Yeah, I mean, you don't want to feel as if
Do you know this girl?
She's... I will say I've seen her in the community.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, I mean, when you're forced to, literally be captive in your own home because there's a bunch of men outside your
street.
Door.
So
yeah, on our fucking street.
People, I just want to clarify. Like, this was not chaos. Like, people are using that to defend the police, that, oh, there was no chaos. The police let us walk by just fine and told us to go to our house. But that's my point. What were they looking for?
Let me finish.
Like, who were they looking for? Like, if there was no chaos, then what do you need machine guns for?
Babe, I have an answer. I found it.
Okay.
All right, so the union leader just put out a new article I found on Facebook during the commercial break. Apparently, this was talked about there. I missed this part, but according to an alderman, the police were looking for a weapon.
So
a Westside alderman said police were searching for a weapon and citizens were safer inside until it was found.
What kind of weapon?
A firearm.
So you need to shut down like a whole city.
Maybe a knife.
You need to shut down a whole neighborhood
Not
to
just
look
lockdown.
For a gun. And they had multiple helicopters.
Yeah, they had like two helicopters up, roadblocks everywhere, SWAT teams, bearcats.
When do they need helicopters to look for a weapon? Like, does this happen every time?
They were scared that someone might find it and use it for evil. I don't know. I mean, I'm trying to understand this rationale. There's a loose gun somewhere, so we're going to fucking lock down the entire west side of Manchester over a gun that can't be found.
Yeah. I'm sorry, like, even that statement, like, trying to answer the question so vaguely, like, police need to be held accountable. They need to give all information. Like, how can you just blindly trust them with your life?
I don't get it.
You wouldn't walk up to any given stranger on the street and just, like, pledge your allegiance to him. Why do that to the state and these cops you've never even met who will not hesitate to put a gun to your fucking head or your kids or your dogs? Like, who cares? Like, they don't care. And I feel like that was just, like, a display of that when they shut our street down. Like, they said there was no chaos. Like, it was just they're searching for a weapon, but we can't leave our houses. We can't walk our dogs. There are guys with AR-15s on the street. Like, I don't get it.
At what point is, like, if you're a cop, like, at what point do you just keep going along? Like, I'm sorry, but
like,
I don't...
Like, have your Edward Snowden moment and just be like, this shit ain't
right. I remember the days before 9/11. I remember... Even back then, police sucked. They really fucking sucked, but it wasn't like it is today.
Yeah, remember Boys in the Hood?
Yeah, it's like...
Fuck police coming straight from the underground.
At some point, you're not protecting. You're an oppressor. Like, and there's no need for them to have so much weaponry. And maybe, just maybe, if you stopped locking away people and putting them into cages for victimless fucking crimes, you wouldn't have gangs building up, defending their, drug trafficking and stuff like that, because they can literally, open up a store and sell it. And maybe, even though I disagree with it, you can tax it and get your cut of it.
No, fuck that. I'm done with half-assing it. Like, I see, like, these activists every day, like, posting on Facebook, like, oh, you should really vote, like, the Libertarian ticket, because this is our best chance at liberty. Yeah. Fuck that. No. The state is what's broken. The state is what's the problem. Like, it doesn't matter. You're not gonna change a person in the system and that make a difference. It's making no fucking difference. Like, you're voting for an oppressor.
I'm not gonna vote. Look,
fuck that.
I'll meet you halfway.
No,
I'm not gonna vote in the federal election. I always say that and keep. I never will again
in any election.
But
fuck
but
it.
I'm
that
okay
wrong.
With anarchists running in the system.
No,
look,
it's like running in the Klan.
I would not be sitting here if it wasn't for Ron Paul, and a lot of fucking anarchists out there can say the exact same goddamn thing.
You don't know Ron Paul.
It was an educational platform.
You don't know.
If you're running on an educational platform, I don't.
You don't know Ron Paul, and I feel like he was very honest with his views and opinions. I feel like a lot of libertarians that run for the state house, they're like they change their views, they falter, like they compromise. I did not see Ron Paul compromising. I saw him calling Congress authoritarian psychopaths. Like, he kept it real.
Oh yeah, he definitely
the whole
did. Oh, yeah.
time. And that's my problem with libertarians. They don't keep it real. They like adjust so they can win, so they can be into this system. Like, if I like joining the Klan and like murdering just a few people, I
there,
guess
I will
know,
give you
but
credit.
It's crazy.
There are libertarians
I
that
it.
Believe
and I see people
they
like
believe
changing.
That somehow they can win and like change the system from within. The only reason you should ever run on a federal ticket, or even like state for that matter, but really federal, if you're ever going to run for anything, like you run as an educational platform, try and wake people up. Like, that's your activism.
I mean,
assume like if you actually get something cool passed, you know, like who gives a fuck about laws? Like, I guess that's a win, but
yeah,
it's
but
like,
it changes
it's like
you.
You're in this cruise liner and you need to literally turn around and you turn it by like, you know, 1 degree.
Yeah.
Like, that's what, cool. Like,
yeah.
That was a lot of work for like little payoff.
For nothing. I mean, I feel like it changes it. Like, it just changes my views and opinions on it. Like, I used to be more open to it. And now I'm just, like, full anarchist. Like, I'm not open to it. Like, I see a deep problem, something that's deeply wrong and disturbing. And I don't think it's going to change with one person. Well, another testimony when we come back.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of
you
people
there. You
know
what I want to do? I want to go old school here. I want to throw up a Ron Paul video. Yeah. Let's find the first one. What's the first one? Democrat versus Republican. That's an ad. Let me find.
He does the one with the words I like. It's like a collage and it's his words. The Free State Project.
Oh, I know what I want to play. I want to pay Ron Paul.
Pledge to move to New Hampshire and get active to achieve liberty in our lifetime.
Perhaps
you're
speech.
Trying to figure out what part of New Hampshire should be your destination. If
it's 48 minutes long.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to do it in 2 minutes.
We must reject the notion of prior restraint in economic activity, just as we do in the area of free speech and religious liberty. Claiming there is a choice of a little tyranny is like describing pregnancy as a touch of pregnancy. It is a myth to believe that a mixture of free markets and government central economic planning is a worthy compromise. The wealth we see today is based on debt and a foolish willingness on the part of foreigners to take our dollars for goods and services. Then they loan them back to us to perpetuate our debt system. It's amazing that it has worked for this long, but the impasse in Washington in solving our problems indicate that many are starting to understand the seriousness of this worldwide debt crisis and the dangers we face. The problem we have faced over the years has been that economic interventionists are swayed by envy.
This is like a bad montage. I'm not feeling it. Like, I figured it'd be a better montage. I was hoping better. I was really hoping better.
Well, I told you, you should have just got the one I said.
Let me take a look here. I don't know if we have enough time before we come back.
Probably not. Just play some music.
Nah, I don't have time to find something. I've run websites since the what if one is probably
yeah,
the best.
Yeah, the one with the worries, is it?
All right.
Madam Speaker, I have a few questions for my colleagues.
Oh, no, you got like two.
What if our foreign policy of the past century is deeply flawed and has not served our national security interests? What if we wait one day and realize that the terrorist threat is a predictable consequence of our meddling in the affairs of others and has nothing to do with us being free and prosperous? What if propping up repressive regimes in the Middle East endangers both the United States and Israel? What if occupying countries like Iraq and Afghanistan and bombing Pakistan is directly related to the hatred directed toward us? What if someday it dawns on us that losing over 5,000 American military personnel in the Middle East since 9/11 is not a fair trade-off for the loss of nearly 3,000 American citizens, no matter how many Iraqi, Pakistani, and Afghan people are killed or displaced? What if we finally decide that torture, even if called enhanced interrogation technique, is self-destructive and produces no useful information?
I'm not feeling the remastered version of this. I don't remember all these sound effects and the music.
I think it sounds good. I think you're like being too choosy. You just ruined his speech. I was into it.
What if all wartime spending is paid for through the deceitful and evil process of inflating and borrowing?
Okay, that's kind of weird.
We finally see that wartime. I'm not feeling the metal. I'm not a big metal fan.
Yeah, that was kind of weird.
Like, I don't know. I used to be a metal guy back in the day, and well, new metal. I mean,
yeah, babe, I get like, it. You were a nerd. I got it.
Hey, am I bringing it back? You bringing it back?
You.
You're putting all the pressure on me. This is what you do. You do this to me all the fucking time.
Just bring up a speed. I don't think I ever do it to you.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. We are playing all the different little speeches that people made in front of the city council here in Manchester over protesting the unjust occupation, and I call it an occupation. I mean, how they treated the West Side, it was complete martial law. And I got queued up here a video of this person. I give it 99% chance this is not a pork, talking about how she lives in Concord with friends. I want you guys to hear her firsthand experience of what it's like living under martial law with the Manchester Police Department.
About 3 o'clock in the morning, myself and 3 friends we heard that there were police outside and that the bear cat was coming, and we had no idea really what was going on, but we went around and we walked through the streets. We passed probably, I would say 4 or 5 different checkpoints where the police were set up at intersections and they were blocking off the streets. Not one had said anything to us about not being able to be on the streets, that we shouldn't be in the area. Nobody really even acknowledged our presence. We did come to one intersection that we were asked to please move it along a couple blocks, which we complied. About 2 blocks after that, we were about halfway down the road, and I want to say it was Rimmon, and this is all on video as well, so I can't remember the details, but it is videotaped. We were about halfway down the street when I would say 6 to 8 officers turned a floodlight on, pointed their rifles at me and my 3 friends, screamed at us to put our hands on our effing heads, turn around, and walk backwards towards them. If we were to turn around, we were really afraid that we would have been shot. We identified ourselves as we walked. We are 4 citizens. We don't know what's going on. We've been walking around all night. We have about half an hour of video. It didn't matter. We were told to shut the F up, shut the F up, and also to other foul language. Now, I appreciate.
She has video of this?
Apparently. I've never seen video of this. I'd love to see it.
Me too.
And what really struck me, aside from the fact that I had guns pointed at my head, was that when we finally did approach the officers, what I saw in their eyes was fear. And it was absolute fear. And
these were young people that were put into a situation where they were essentially making an enemy out of the citizens.
Maybe it was evil, she was saying.
Of their city. And
yeah,
I don't think
it's fair.
I think
it's more evil.
Any of these officers go to work with the intent of, you know, let's oppress people and let's oppress them. And but that's what happened. And
who is this girl?
I don't know.
Okay. Probably just
she's
a
not,
citizen.
She's not,
then.
She's not a pork.
And everybody else.
I'm almost guaranteed. I almost guarantee it.
That is not how you police a town. That's how war mentality begins. Us versus them. In 2012, ACLU posted a very in-depth study regarding this mentality of militarization, and I don't want to see that in New Hampshire. We probably, you know, can brag about. In my opinion, it's one of the best places to live in the country. And I don't want to see my streets turn into a war zone. And that's what I saw. And I was afraid for my life that night because I realized these guys don't know what they're doing. They don't know how to handle it. They're doing the best they can.
Now, I believe
afraid.
That.
And they had guns pointed at my
no,
head.
Not the afraid part. They don't know what they're doing. Yeah. They can't handle it. And they're pointing
and,
guns because they're pussies with guns.
Is there anyone
else wishing to speak? I mean, well articulated. Well, very well articulated. I'll give her that. But like I said, I'm full anarchist. And it's just like, no. Like, if you don't want to do this, throw your fucking gun down then and quit. Say no. Walk the fuck away. This is wrong. Like, Edward Snowden did it. You know, he did it on a larger scale, and you're just a fucking, if it's just your job, if you're just doing your job, then if you don't want to do your job anymore, quit, and then I'll have respect for you, cop.
At what point, like, we're talking about earlier, like, at what point does, well, are you willing to go as a cop? Like, how many, you know, orders do you follow?
Like
a soldier, like.
The state says go, take this. Oh, I'll be your thief. The state says go kill these people. I'll be your murderer. The state, like, what else do they have to say? Get down on your knees, open your mouth, barrel, like, in it. Like,
have you ever heard of Oath Keepers? I'm asking you, babe. Have you heard of Oath Keepers?
Is that from Game of Thrones?
Oathkeepers.org. All right. Oathkeepers.org. I'm not a huge fan of them. I get what they're doing. I used to like them a lot more. I think they made a whole lot of mistakes. Anyways, Oathkeepers.org, it's for active military and retired military and police, police and whatnot. Because, you know, when they take their role, you know, within the government, you know, they take an oath of office to uphold and defend the Constitution against enemies, foreign and domestic. Mm-hmm. And they kind of hold them to that ground where, like, if you go there and like, sign up, like, you have to say that you will not follow any, like, especially for, it's more for military, but it applies here for police. But you will not do anything, follow any rule
so
or
like
any
the,
order that violates the Constitution. You will not
it's
do
like
it. You will
stand down. It's like the doctor's oath to do no harm.
I guess that's probably the best equivalent.
Yeah.
But their whole purpose is to prevent people from, not prevent people, but to help people from the inside.
From their heads exploding with the power that they want so bad. Oath Keepers.
Yeah. Well, no, I get what they're doing.
Bringing them down to earth. Like, how about you don't, like, do anything that's unconstitutional?
Well, I get what you're saying on that, but like Oath Keepers, like, for the most part, like they're like, you know, they're trying to do their thing from the inside, okay? So like they're trying, like, this is activism, like, I don't agree with, but like they're trying to change the Klan.
What's it gonna take for you?
For me? What do you mean for me?
I mean, like, you know, I feel like you're still a little bit statist. Like,
Wait, whoa.
You're like, I'll take a smaller government before the no government, like, if that's how it has to happen. I'm like, fuck that. Like, the smaller government is going to be just as bad as the
you
already government.
You think I'm a statist?
Yeah.
You think you're more anarchist than I am?
I've never voted, So just stepped over the line there. Look, ran into the end zone.
Just stab me in the fucking back. I am sorry. Forgive me, Father, for I have fucking sins.
I will stab you in the front because it's the truth. And I just like, I mean, I get your points. I can empathize with you. But for me, it's like honor your oath. And it's like this American flag in the background. Like the Constitution is nothing more than a fucking piece of paper.
Hey, George Bush was right about that. You know, like you gotta give the man credit where credit is due.
Okay, we're gonna have the best video when we come back. From the sriracha guy himself.
Went full anarchist on Mitch.
In local news, 23-year-old graffiti artist Adam
good,
Zane.
Good, take back and go, babe. I love that. That was cool. Zane, who goes by the graffiti Oathkeepers. There's a nonpartisan association of current and former.
I'd rather hear money. I mean, I'd rather hear music.
I know. All right. Duly noted. Really just the absolute worst. Let me see here. Let me see. What to put on?
An excited groom sends text messages to his buddies during his bride's vows, and a collection of VHS tapes are held onto for one more year. In other news, a burglar makes sure to crack the glass on a family portrait before leaving. There's nothing in the employee handbook about groping dead co-workers, an employee says, and a report finds that nobody's heard from David Blaine in a while, so somebody should probably check to see if he died in one of those things. Mere seconds have passed, yet we feel as though we've known you a thousand lifetimes. For more, visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
This is the Onion News Network.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a...
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. This is your Rebel Mistress here. So we're talking about some of our experiences, good and bad, about the events that took place Friday the 13th. What month was that?
That
April?
Was May.
May? No. Friday
sure
the
13th. Was it April? No. Was it April?
It was recently.
Yeah, it was recently.
It was recently. Anyway,
Shot of time just messes up your whole frame.
It messes
of reference.
Up your thought like, process. Yeah, but anyway, before we get too off topic, I did want to say I have just almost released a new book. It's called In Love Words. In Love Words.
Ooh, what is it about, baby doll?
It's a book of love poems, actually. It's the Valentine's Day edition. It was really nice, and you can check it out. Just look for it. It should be out in a few weeks. In Love Words by the Rebel Mistress on Audible and iTunes and all that good stuff. But anyway, so this has been a great show. So we did save the best for last here. Like I said, I haven't heard any of these, so these are all like my first like time hearing and like going in on it. And someone came up to Randy Clemens, who's been on our show. He's the Sriracha guy, author of the Sriracha Cookbook. You can go find that on Amazon as an ebook, or you can probably
I'm sure you're
yeah and or
he needs
Amazon.
An audiobook for
yeah I
cookbook.
Keep saying that like if he
I
pays me I'll do
why.
It
he should pay you with a bunch of
yeah
a,
I'll make
Ethereum
it extra sexy I'll take Ethereum
yeah know,
Randy Clemens if you're listening anyway
you take the E all night long
it was I don't know if it was one of the
did I play Carla's video of in the city council
yeah you did
okay
it was definitely you made me forget what I was gonna say it was definitely one of the city hall officials who came up to Randy after, and they were like, I really liked what you had to say.
Oh, did that happen?
Yeah. It was that old guy who came up to Randy after, when you guys came outside.
I missed that part.
Yeah. So there was a guy who came up to Randy, and I'm guessing I wasn't in there, so I don't know specifically, but he was this older guy with a suit on, and he was like, I just wanted to let you know, I thought you articulated yourself very well. I didn't know that this was happening here tonight, so like this really amazed me.
Oh, maybe it was someone that went there for some other reason.
No, it was that old guy right there.
Oh, it's sitting back here?
Yeah, it was one of those guys.
Oh. Okay.
And I was like, that's how you know you did a good job. Anyway.
All right, so yeah, this is Randy Clemens here. This is the man, the myth, the legend that went full, you know, freedom on the oppressive city council.
Randy Clemens, 77 Direct Court in Manchester. I would like to know where this ends. There's clearly no de-escalation happening, and I think the police are becoming quite skilled at doublespeak and saying one thing and doing another. And so when we bring these problems to them, the solution continually seems to be, we need more police, we need more money, we need more laws passed. It's just more, it's more, it's more. It builds up and it builds a house of cards. And so now we have people who aren't able to leave their homes, we have people who aren't able to drive home because we have these suspicious DUI checkpoints. We have people who aren't able to possess a plant because someone has deemed it immoral. I see a police force that is growing increasingly at odds with the views of the people it's purporting to protect. And I don't see this going positively. I see us coming here with a problem, and I see the answer being more police, more training, more money, and it's coming out of our pockets. I got my tax bill today. It's not friendly. It's not nice at all, and I'm not getting anything that I'm enjoying for my services other than this beautiful state that we're in and my great friends, but the police are not providing a service that I want any part of. I feel much safer if they weren't around. So with that said, I would very clearly like to state that I don't want any more money going towards this department in any fashion for any reason. Thank you.
Striking at the roots, at the freaking balls.
That was
of
it.
The police. Yeah, that was it. You only get a little bit of time.
That
hey, he
was
dropped
it.
The mic.
That was
a mic drop. That was the last
the
one.
The mic, yeah. But I really like Britney's better. Like, it was more heartfelt.
Yeah, she was talking as a mother with her kids and crying.
Yeah,
about it. Yeah.
I don't know.
I
feel like
you,
I'm like very. I'm like this mush pool. I don't know. But
well, that's because you're baby crazy. That's why. I mean, let's talk about that.
Like, it's somebody's baby, like out there,
I know.
Like that the police are pointing guns at. Poor baby. That could be my baby.
It could have been all of our babies. It takes a tribe, baby. All babies are everyone's baby. If you think about it, we're all human beings.
That's true. But anyway, no, I really did like Randy's speech though, and I love that he brought in Decrim with it and the suspicionless checkpoints. Like, sum it all up, it is going into what I was just like screaming about earlier, which is that it's all the system, like all the problems. It's not just this one problem, it's all the problems that we've been facing, because they're trying to turn this into a police state. They're doing it right under our noses. A lot of people are playing into it and like rewarding it. But again, like Randy said, like, yeah, where does it end? So I guess that was good, because like, can anyone answer that? Like, where does it stop? And I don't feel like it will. Like, soon there'll be a curfew. Like, there's already a curfew worldwide. Like, you're not even free. Like, you're free to go out of your house at anytime, but the city deems that every establishment has to close at a certain time. There are some 24 hours, but they're like, clubs can't stay open that late, bars can't stay open that late. Like, why? Like, they're already limiting you. They're already telling, you know, you what you can and can't do. Like, when does it end? Like,
well, I mean, yeah, you're not free. I mean, you're free as long as you pay your property taxes. I mean, you don't pay your property taxes, what do you think they're gonna do? You're not even free in your own home. They will take your home.
They can take your home.
They will kick you out and take it.
Yeah.
And then sell it. They'll make a profit off of it.
Yeah. And they're doing it every single day. And they're using your tax dollars to do it, to rob people. And you're contributing to war. And it's just like this whole vicious cycle, an oppressive cycle. And where does it end? He's right. Like, I don't know. I don't see very good things coming. It looks like, even though, you know, politics are stupid, like, I feel like this particular presidential election is extra redonkulous, because everyone is absolutely ridiculous.
You know, I think
it's
Hillary,
like,
got enough superdelegates.
Yeah, no, she did. She won. It was trending on Facebook.
Yeah.
But anyway, so yeah, Hillary. But it's just like everyone's like lining up. Have you seen that new purge preview? It's like, I purge today, and it's crazy. And that's how I see the presidential candidates. It's like, I'm a war criminal, I'm a future war criminal, I'm a wannabe war criminal. And everyone's just smiling about it and just happy and cheery. Like, it's just horrible. And I see, like, you know, society collapsing because of it.
Do you think will help facilitate the a collapse of the federal government faster, Donald Trump or Hillary Clinton?
I kind of like it's a tie.
Why?
Like,
why is it a tie?
It's a tie because, like, in different ways. Like, first of all, I feel like when Hillary gets it, like, it's between Trump and Hillary. But when and if Hillary gets it, that will spark about more anarchy. Yeah, fuck that shit. That will spark about more anarchy quicker because everyone hates Hillary Clinton. Like, seriously, like, she has not. I've never heard anything favorable
ever. You should
ever.
Be proud like, even of the status. Fact that she is the first woman to be running as the like on a national party for president. Like, and actually
she is
get
this
the nomination
evil
or
like
whatever.
Twat. Like, that's the only thing I can like think of. Like, she get her face gives me a bad trip. Like, she's just evil, and she's contributed to so much war. It's like, just elect the better war criminal. The war criminal you know. The war criminal you can trust. Like, yeah. So, I mean, I feel like with her, like, at least people will start to, like, see that their vote doesn't matter.
And at the end of the day, it doesn't matter because...
Even the rednecks will see their vote doesn't matter.
Look,
it's already rigged, okay?
The Bilderbergers get the pick. They're going to pick this week, I think. They have, like, some sort of...
And they're
going to
pick Hillary. And, like...
No, they could pick Trump.
If Trump wins, here's my thing. If Trump wins, it's the same thing. It's collapse into chaos. It's like sliding into chaos. But this chaos is going to be even more bloody quicker.
You know what? I would actually like to see.
Because he's a violent man. And you know what he says about militarization of the police? Because someone yelled, oh, go Trump. He says that the police are being disrespected. And police need to be held on a pedestal. And they need to be treated right. And they're afraid to do their job. And what the fuck? Like, seriously? That's what America is looking forward to.
We're gonna get what we deserve, folks.
Who's this we?
Oh, I'm sorry. They're gonna get what they deserve. Just leave me the fuck alone.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it, and once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world, so I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something
important
is happening
here. Oh, I want
to
play this one,
babe. And I just wanted to come to sort
of
be part of
this one. I found a good one. Okay, I want
to.
You said you wanted music, right?
Declaration.
Yeah, you said you wanted music. That's right.
Liberty.
This was a rebel, and he rose.
Through the Shire.
He's from
Come on, that was cute. That was cute.
What if you could include a bonus?
I have never played it on air before. That was the first time I ever played it on the show.
Tip returned to you if unclaimed after 30 days. An attractive business card Bitcoin tip.
What else have I posted?
Claimed, gives instructions on wallets and spending.
Oh, I can play the video of you.
Unused. Tip.freetalklive.com. Tip.freetalklive.com.
Now that you've found the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm, you may want to help expose others to our
great
programs. To assist you in doing so, you'll find resources at promote.lrn.fm, including details on how to get a free bumper sticker, quarter-page flyers you can print out and distribute, banners for your website, as well as files that will allow you to make your own custom banners and graphics. Visit promote.lrn.fm and help bring new listeners to the Liberty Radio Network. That's promote.lrn.fm.
Look at Ash.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what.
Have
the
you bringing it back, by the way?
About, but it's an effort to move 20,000 people
my
who
turn.
Understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country.
Yeah, we can
it's been
have
a, while,
a free market, a truly free market,
making it just a freer, great place to live.
I had a shot, but that's because you pressure kids. Yeah, but the penis thing. Besides that, I'm trying to
say yes. I missed it. Oh my god.
Oh, that's so fat.
What the Free State Project.
I had a shot.
Judge people.
Here we go.
Yeah,
it's gorgeous.
Oh, those are gorgeous titties. Yeah. They still are.
I can't wait to take a hiatus from the show. Here in New Hampshire,
what? Yeah. I'm not annoying. What are you talking about? A documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. Oh, the artsy-fartsy video.
To announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices.
Ash just muscled her way into the studio. Check this out. Ash, you like, you opened up the fucking door up there. Yeah, okay, I know.
Please download, rate us 5 stars, then share the link on your social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.FM. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Tuesday, gold is down $7 at $1,241 per ounce. Silver is off 11 cents at $16.42 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $583. Robertson Roberts Brokerage has been helping clients buying and selling gold and silver for nearly 40 years. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.com.
This isn't good, babe.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, guys. And, I don't know, throughout the Shire years that I've been here, it's been a lot. Where are we at? 8 years? Shire years?
I don't know. You're like you're the crazy.
Am I the crazy?
You're like the fucking Mad Hatter over here with time. Like, it's been like 8 years.
I'm the crazy one. You can't say the kettle's black, you know, or whatnot. When you're calling me like crazy, I'm the crazy one. Like, you got the...
Baby, are you trying to say I'm crazy?
It's been two years. 2 years.
So even if it was Shire years, it'd be like 3 years, not two years.
No, what? Your math is all wrong on that. Your math is all wrong.
Anywho.
So my point being is I've been going through, like, phases. I've definitely evolved and changed. Like, literally, like, every few months, I feel like I'm a whole different person. And I don't know. The more and more, I'm getting burnt out. So, like, I've been sitting on this court video. I have a court date coming up, July 14th. If you want to come to it. I'm most likely make a Facebook event. I'll get around to it. I have court video of the pretrial, which dates back to an incident that happened outside our studio back in December. And the longer it drags out, I'll be honest, I'm getting tired. Like, I'm not a right to travel activist. I look at the video. I don't like the video.
I don't know why you don't
I could
it.
Play on air as like a like you know like the un like the
yeah
raw
play
version.
Us a little snippet.
You want to play? All right, I'll play a snippet of
this.
This
is
here.
Rob's court video, oh. Which he won, right?
Did I? No, I did not win this. Like
win? You had to pay.
That's what my court date is for July 14th.
Okay,
this is the
pre-trial
to it. I haven't. There hasn't been the decision yet. So like that's why I haven't played it yet. What are you doing? Jesus, you really fucking hate that cat.
No, she's like rubbing her tail on me. Can you please just
play
the video?
Oh, my God.
Good.
You're crazy.
All right, I'm in front of the 9th District Court here in Manchester, New Hampshire. I'm fighting a ticket that I got back in December. I got a ticket from the Merrimack County Sheriff's Department, which doesn't have jurisdiction in Hillsborough County, which I am right now. And they gave me a ticket walking into my home for not having registration, and they did that because I was approached to talk about someone else that they were looking for, and I wouldn't cooperate with the police, so they decided to write me a ticket. Now, mind you, I know that I don't even need a piece of paper. No, this is my registration. I know I don't need this to drive because, like, I should be able to freely drive no matter where I go, but every activist picks and chooses a battle. That's why I have this. Now, I'm not even here as a right to travel activist. I'm here because of...
I'll fast forward to the part of the cop.
Then why do that?
It's, like, long. There's a lot of...
Why not?
If you're going to suspend the fine, fantastic. What's the difference? Throw it out.
Because then you have...
Do you like the music in the background?
I want to hear
conviction on your record so that you can get another one.
But from your perspective, and you're not taking any money, more money from me. So in that respect, why don't you just throw it out?
Okay, then Lane, we'll throw it out and you pay the fine. We'll go to trial.
Let's go to trial.
Okay.
I mean, if you're... But you're offering to throw it out, not throw it out, you're suspend the fine. If you're going to suspend the fine, what's...
Because
it goes on forever. Like, it goes on forever. I gotta edit that down. Then this is the part where, I was trying different music.
I mean, but in the end of the day, like, I feel like with this video and with everything we've been talking about today, you didn't do anything wrong. It doesn't matter what the police, like, I feel like you feel guilty or something because the police were, like, at our house and, like, you knew the person. It doesn't get fucking matter. That person doesn't live with us. They didn't have a warrant for our house. They were simply harassing you. Like, and you have video of them harassing you, and that's not right. Like, you gotta stand up for yourself. Like, I don't feel like you did anything wrong in this situation. Like, at all. Like, 0%. Like, you did nothing wrong.
No, I know. I definitely didn't do anything wrong. I get that. It's just, I don't know. I'm just getting burnt out from it. You know, I don't know. I'm going to put this
out. Is that
out.
The guy who said it's my Shire now?
No. The sheriff did. This motherfucker right here. This guy. This is where, like, he said that. But unfortunately, I don't have that, which is another reason why I don't even really want to release this. Oh, by the way, there's this weird moment, too, in the video where one of the other... this person I know is a Manch person. I've seen her in the courtroom multiple times. But she gave me a different paper, all right, which didn't make any sense. Like she had me switch.
It's all about dotting your I's and crossing your T's with the state.
Yeah, we only do Manchester
police. We don't do other counties.
Okay.
It was really weird. So anyways, yeah, she gave me that, but, like, the court
I mean, that's
kind of
boring. I mean, I guess you should shorten it.
No, the reason why I left that in there is because the court date was originally when I got that piece of paper, July 15th, and you actually hear Renee saying July 15th. This paper, on the other hand, is July 14th. They changed the date, immediately, and it was really weird. I captured it on film. It was just, like, a weird thing. Like, you literally just handed me the exact same paper, just the date is different. So I thought that was really odd. And also I was questioning her about, like, you know, Merrimack County sheriffs in their courthouse. Like, why? Is this normal? Do they normally do this? Like, it just seems like an odd thing for that to happen.
I guess. I mean, okay.
See
but,
why I don't even care to release it? It's so,
no,
it's
I feel
so
like
you niche.
Should,
it's so
maybe
niche.
You should release it, but you should shorten it down definitely, like, intensely and only keep, like, highlights.
You're right. I gotta shorten it down to, like, a 2-minute video.
Yeah,
I have two minutes at max.
I don't
have the raw stuff. I can cut it down to, like, a couple different
moments. You're a video editor extraordinaire. Like, don't be.
Look, I appreciate you stroking my ego.
I'm not stroking your ego. I don't stroke anyone's ego. Like, I don't believe in stroking of egos. Like, I just speak the truth, yo. But anywho, it's been a crazy week with this activism. Do you foresee us doing any more activism in the near future?
Of course.
Well, I feel like HempFest is activism within itself.
Yeah, I view HempFest as... this state's probably its best chance to get legalization. It's building up as a huge festival, music festival, but Rick Nye is, like, building a he's really building a entire, like,
a masterpiece,
an army of people pushing legalization. Like, he's getting people that run for governor that want to come to HempFest and talk about legalization.
Yeah.
You know, like, that he's building those
and
ties.
And even though I don't necessarily believe in the state, like,
neither
I feel
do I,
like that's a great step,
like,
because, like,
anyone that's going to
like Randy said, like, as long as they're arresting people for plans, like, we can never progress.
And, I don't get me wrong, I don't want the state to be there, but I'm going to support. This is, like, me supporting, like, activism within the inside without participating. Like, this is the closest I want to get. But, like, what he's doing is definitely helping out, and
no victim, no crime.
This is the best chance we got right now to end prohibition in New Hampshire. And
what do you see it ending?
Do I see it ending? Nah. You know what?
I do eventually, especially for pot. Hopefully, pot has to be legal within the next two years.
Well, as you were going to say, like, they're going to make medical MDMA in the next 5 years, apparently.
Well, I'm going to cover that next prohibition episode. We'll talk about
that. That would be nice. Talk about, you know, some addict psychedelic effects. But anyway, I mean, it was a successful protest today. Did you release all your photos already? No, or you got more to come?
One of my passions is Instagram. I actually really like my Instagram. I actually like that more than like doing this show, to be perfectly honest.
That can be your new activism.
That I already do that. Anyways, Instagram.com/volunteersrebel. Just find me at volunteersrebel.
I need to change my Instagram handle.
Yeah, you do. Anyhow. Last Dahlia is just like...
Oh, is it Last Dahlia?
Yeah, it's Last Dahlia. You got to change it.
Go find me on Instagram, Last Dahlia.
You never post on Instagram. It's like once
sometimes.
In a blue moon.
I don't have a phone that I can find. Anywho.
If you can find it, charged.
Where can they find your latest stuff and things?
Oh, if you go there, I took a bunch of photos during this protest. We got some gems.
So go like Rebel Love Show
Vegas. Yeah, it'll
on
be
Facebook.
I'll have a blog post out to both rebellovshow.com and
Freaking. Oh, you're going to write a blog post?
Yeah, I got to. I'm probably going to make
a video,
too.
Could we co-write a blog post?
Babe, you were there. Just make your own blog post. I'm sure Ian will let you blog post, too.
I don't want to. I mean, we're
blog it to rebellovshow.com. You have blog actually. Okay, I guess we can make a joint one. Like, you're the one that went on and on about how people have joint Facebook accounts.
So go like us on Facebook.
Some balls. I'm telling you right now. Like, you got this, too. I got you got it. We'll both can do a blog post.
Fine.
To our website. We can both make blog posts about what happened there.
Fine. Right. Go like my Facebook page as well. I like blogging. I feel like once I retire from this show, like I'll like focus more heavily on blogging. Maybe that'll be a good project. But anyway, go buy your tickets to HempFest.
At HempFest.com.
And
this
RebelLoveShow.com.
Chance to get tickets under $100. Don't miss it. And yeah, RebelLoveShow.com. Go subscribe to us on iTunes, Stitcher, YouTube, and Facebook.
Peace
guys.